In my opinion, libertarianism is really idiotic. It's based on a lot of really foolish beliefs. Number one, that the market somehow has magical self-regulating properties, that the market can regulate itself without help from the government.
From what I understand, you hold a position that the government should regulate the market. Well, then who should regulate the government? Who should regulate those who regulate the government? And who should regulate them? Ultimately, a hierarchical form of regulation is self-defeating. Because there is no such thing as a supreme regulator who does not need to be regulated themselves.
And I've asked them why they think this, and this is what they tell me. They say that if a corporation acts poorly, that the people will find out about it, and the people will not buy their products, and therefore corporations won't act badly, and the market will regulate itself. This all sounds good, I guess, if you're a 12-year-old and you've not observed the world as we live in at all. But in the real world we live in, that's simply not possible. People are stupid. People are dumb, ignorant, lazy-minded monkeys. They go to work 8, 9, 10 hours a day. They come home, do their chores, go do their dry cleaning, wash their clothes, clean their houses, wash their cars. They just want to watch a little TV, play a little video games, meet a girl, have some sex. They don't have time to sit around and research every product they buy before they buy it. Nobody does this.
Let us assume that you are correct. That one, people do not have the time to research a product before they buy it, and that two, even if they did have the time, they would be too stupid to make a rational decision in the first place. If that is true, then what makes the government immune from this? What makes you think that people do not have the time to research a product, but that they do have the time to research a policy or candidate to be voted on? What makes you think that people are too stupid to buy the right product, but are smart enough to cast the correct vote in the ballot box?
And that's evident if you just look at companies like BP. How much oil did BP dump into our oceans? And they had the highest profit margins they've ever had. The market does not regulate itself, it cannot regulate itself, and the thought that it can is totally idiotic.
BP's safety procedures were and are explicitly regulated by the government. If anything, the BP oil spill is even more evidence that government regulation doesn't work. The fact that BP still exists at all is due to government-created limited liability.
The truth is, if you're paying attention at all, people are terrible. They're terrible, selfish assholes who would do whatever they can to get over their fellow man, just even a little bit. And that's why we have to have an organization that protects the people against each other and against corporations.
And who protects us against the protectors? You imply that libertarians have a magical belief system. But how rational is it to believe that everyone is a terrible, selfish asshole who will do whatever they can to exploit one another, except when they call themselves the government? What magical force makes politicians immune from corruption? The solution to corruption is not to simply hand all of the power into the hands of a group of individuals calling themselves the state and then hoping that they won't abuse it. The solution is to structure society so that people are incentivized to compete against each other on the basis of price and quality, rather than on the basis of who can obtain monopoly privileges through bribing the right politician.
People are always complaining that corporations have bought our government. The reason that they're allowed to do that is not because of too much regulation, it's because of too little regulation. There should be so much regulation against corporations lobbying our government that there's no way they could do it. There should be government-run watchdogs who keep a constant eye on every corporation to make sure they can't get their dirty money anywhere near our politicians.
And who watches the watchdogs? Who watches the watchdog watchers? Who watches the watchdog watcher watchers? And so on and so on. Again, you are not proposing a solution. You are merely begging the question. You are committing the same logical fallacy as a theist arguing that everything must have a creator, therefore God must have created everything. The reason that corporations are allowed to exist in the first place is entirely due to the government. And the reason that they are allowed to buy the government is because politicians have the incentive to sell their power. Again, the problem of corruption can only be solved by having the correct incentives, not by believing that there are godlike individuals in the government who will protect us. Let's say that a business is secretly adding something to their product that is unhealthy to consumers, but reduces their cost. The entities with the highest incentive to investigate, uncover, and expose this secret are the other businesses that are competing against them. Not some politician who would be more than happy to classify their harmful additive as a trade secret and thus make it illegal to expose it.
It always, always, always leads to corporatism. I mean, how could it not? If there's no regulations to stop these people with all this money from buying the government, then that's exactly what they're going to do.
Can you please explain how this would be possible? Let's say that there is a law passed that clearly states that all regulatory laws are now null and void, and it is now illegal to pass any law which will regulate any particular businesses or market sectors. How then do politicians grant political favors to businesses if they do not have the power to do so? It is only when society is duped into thinking that government regulations are the solution when politicians then and only then have the power to distort the marketplace. Under the guise of fairness and safety, of course. And when they finally have the power to distort the marketplace, they then have the incentive to sell that power.
So let's say a company does something that harms our environment, that kills a bunch of people. Well, if they can pay those people off cheaper than they can fix the problem, then that's exactly what they'll do.
The foundation of a free market is a court system that respects property rights, meaning that you cannot simply harm the environment without consequence, because the environment will be owned by someone who will then have just cause to sue you for property damage. If a company knowingly does something that will kill a bunch of people, then this is no longer just a matter of civil redress. This becomes a matter of cold-blooded murder. And the thing that stops companies from being charged with murder is the government-granted privilege of limited liability, which has nothing to do with a free market and everything to do with government distortions.
Libertarians don't want the government involved in anything, for somehow they've convinced themselves that the government is evil, but government is not evil. Okay, just because our government is broken does not mean government is not useful.
This is an illogical line of reasoning. Pointing out whether something is useful has no say on whether it is moral. It would certainly be useful for me to point a gun at you and demand your money, but the fact that such an action would be useful does not mean that it is no longer evil.
You can ask them directly, what happens to people that don't have enough money? What happens to people who weren't lucky enough to be rich? What happens to the poor who can't afford their life-saving medical procedures and can't find charity to pay for it? What happens to those people? And the libertarian response, literally, is fuck them. Oh well, they're just unlucky. That's evolution, survival of the fittest. Fuck them, they're just going to suffer and die.
This is a dishonest question. I could just as well ask what happens to someone whose treatment the government has deemed to be too costly. The government is not magic. It too will have to make the decision of how much resources to devote toward medical goods and services, and thus, who lives and who dies. I would love to live in a world where all illness has long been cured, and a life-saving treatment would be as expensive as buying a cell phone. But how we get there is by allowing individuals to interact on a voluntary basis, not by pulling out guns and pointing them at people because we think that we know better than them.
These libertarians, literally, they want to get rid of public education. They think everything should be privatized, even schools. They literally want to take the education of our children and turn it into a contest to see who can make the most money off of it. That's the most fucked up thing I can imagine. The education of our children should not have anything to do with profit margins. It shouldn't fucking be about that. It shouldn't be privatized.
If this is a misunderstanding of libertarianism, I would be all for an education system that was free to the public. What I am against is the idea that it is okay to pull out guns and force people to pay for monopolistic goods and services, such as schools, even if they receive no benefit from that good or service whatsoever. It is irrational fear-mongering to believe that it is impossible to achieve an end, such as educating children, if we do not pull out guns and point them at each other.